What's up, everyone? Nameco here. Fantasy Smack Talk. Week 4, quarter of the way done. It's kind of nuts. And if your team's not doing well, make sure you sign up for FanDuel. If your team's doing well, it means you're good at fantasy. So sign up for FanDuel. Click on the link below. Go ahead, deposit $10. And also, click on the link. Get in our weekly game. We're trying to get 75 people. If you beat us, you're going to get a t-shirt. Plus, you're going to win the cash. So I'm trying to take one home. I've been doing great, actually. Even though my picks were really good last week, I didn't use enough of them, so I'm going to do that this week. And I'm going to start off with quarterbacks for you. The first one is Trevor Siemian. So on FanDuel, he's $7,500. Denver's playing Oakland, and he is the 16th ranked quarterback in terms of FanDuel. We have him at about number 12 or 13 in our weekly rankings. Potentially, by Sunday comes around, I might be bumping him over the likes of like Ben Roethlisberger, Stafford. So due to that, I love his price in FanDuel. The next one's got to be in all your lineups, whether it's FST, whether it's whatever. Big tournaments, I don't care. Best value of the week is Joe Mixon. He's only $5,600. That makes him the 37th ranked running back according to FanDuel. We got him inside our top 12. And I think he has a huge week against the Cleveland Browns. I think he gets 20 plus touches, and I think it's blow-up time for Joe Mixon. So I'm going to have him in literally all of my lineup, just putting that out there right now. And that price is just too good. Sometimes I like to zig when people are zagging, but Mixon is just, the value is too good. Next one is Wendell Smallwood. He was Dustin's pickup of the week, and for good reason, right? Sproles is out for the year. Smallwood's looked good. He's gotten, well, okay, I guess, but he's gotten the touches. He's playing the snaps. Blunt hasn't looked good, and for $5,300, he is a huge value. He is a guy that's kind of a boomer bust, in my opinion. It's a 0.5 PPR, sorry, Matt Smith, I know it's not PPR, I know it's PR, point PR, but still, that's what everybody says. And what happened is, Philly's playing the Chargers, and so Smallwood, I don't think is like a slam dunk, but in bigger tournaments, I do like him for that reason. As I move on to wide receivers, I'm going with Funchess out there with Carolina. $5,400, they're playing New England, and the thing about Funchess, Benjamin's a little bit banged up, I know Newton's not been great, but he got 10 targets last week. And Funchess is a guy that everyone's been waiting in fantasy to break out, and he's at least going to get the opportunity, it looks like, now with Greg Olsen being down. It looks like he's going to be one of the biggest beneficiaries of that. So 10 targets, you know Nameco loves him some targets, so interesting play. Again, he's only $5,400. Next one's a little bit more expensive, but he should be even more, in my opinion. That's Parker for the Miami Dolphins. They're playing New Orleans, who is a terrible secondary, and that's just first and foremost. Parker's looked good, and I know he scared everybody last week, but then in the fourth quarter, he had like 9 catches, I feel, and a touchdown. So for $6,500, I think he's definitely worth a play in tournaments and cash games this week. As I move to tight ends, it's been tough, and I know in season-long leagues too, it's a tough go for tight ends right now. You kind of have the Gronk, the Ertz, the Kelce, and not even really Kelce that much, that you can depend on. Everybody else is a crapshoot, so I'm looking at what defenses give up touchdown to tight ends, and that's the New York Giants. So I got Cameron Brate for $5,300. He is my guy that I think could find the end zone. I do like the him and Winston connection, but tight end might be something where I'm willing to pay up and get a Gronk this week and use some of these other guys. Last but not least, the defense. I go to betting odds, and what I like to do is see what's the lowest over under of the week. Go with the favorite. Since he's the favorite against the Browns, $4,600. It's like a 41 over under. Vegas thinks it's going to be a low scoring game, so I think it's going to be a low scoring game. So that's what I'm doing there. So again, I'm not going to use all of these guys in my lineup, even though I maybe should have done that last week. I'm going to use a good chunk of them and then buy up and get some studs. Hope my studs blow up and hope these guys hit. So that's the move with FanDuel. So again, good luck this season. Good luck week 4. Nameco for Fantasy Smack Talk. I'm out.